we want to plug them in? No? Okay.
Thank you, Lord, for loving me enough to point me to the tree where I am crucified with Christ on Calvary. Thank you, Lord, for loving me enough to point me to the tree where I am crucified with Christ on His wounded hand revealed in all impossible for me. Oh Lord, I long to see the Lamb reaching out his wounded hand revealed in all impossible for me. So yeah. Reaching out his wounded hand revealed in all impossible for me. So yes, oh yes, oh Lord, to the living one in me. Revealed in all impossible for me. Revealed in all impossible for me.
Amen. Ready? I trust you are all ready to the book of Philippians. All right. We're in verse 21. We've been building toward this in this chapter. Paul has been expressing a relationship with God. Remember the first couple of verses, 2 through 6. He's been expressing a relationship with God that is different than what they've had. It doesn't necessarily replace all of that, but it certainly will become the preeminent way of relating to God if one sees it by the unveiling of the Spirit to show us Christ within. And that relationship is that. It is a relationship of an inward Messiah. Not just an outward Messiah, which was the, admitted, that was the big fault of Israel. They were looking for an outward Messiah. And because of their outward concepts, they missed the best thing that ever happened to them. They missed the very thing that they claimed with all their heart to be looking for. They missed it because they had an outward concept instead of an inward concept. Paul, well, he was one of them. He was a Pharisee. He taught that. He was dedicated to that. He had already separated his life unto this Messiah, because that's part of what they preached. But when Christ was revealed in him, and that's, I'm using his words, that's not my words, that's not those deeper life people's words, that is Paul's word. When the Messiah was revealed within him. I mean, come on, think about it. Everything changed. And he was no longer Jewish by religion. In fact, he says, I was outdistancing my brethren in the Jews' religion. Isn't that the words that he uses? I'm pretty sure it is. Okay, I'll trust all of us. Pretty sure that's what he said. And more zealous of the traditions. Yeah, verse 14 said, and profited in the Jews' religion above many mine equals in mine own nation. Profited in the Jews' religion, but folks, he's not, if you understand what I mean, he's not in the Jewish religion anymore. He's in Christ. I mean, you know, he's not Christian, not in the way we use it. I'm sorry, he's not Christian in the way we use it, because he didn't change religions. He came to a revelation of the way God was meant to be. I mean, is that right or wrong? He didn't change. He didn't say, I'm gonna jump ship. And that's the way a lot of the Jews of the Jewish religion viewed him, but that was not his heart. He found the true meaning, the true definitions of God, the true way of God, the true way to relate to God. And part of that was not an outward Messiah, but an inward Messiah. And that's why it says, Messiah was revealed in me. Because that's, if you were in that day, you would understand what that meant. If you were Jewish, if you were one of the first people to hear the message of Paul, you know, and of these guys, you know, Paul's talking about the Messiah. And they're going, yeah. He says, the Messiah was revealed in me. All right. Well, if we comprehend what I've said up to that point, then we have to examine ourselves whether we're in the faith. So that's also the way Paul you put it. But what I mean by that is we have to examine ourselves. Have we backslid? Have we become Jewish in our approach? Or did we join up and automatically in that? where the Messiah that we seek, the one we seek to deliver, is not delivering us from ourselves so much by him being the life and him being the peace and him being the, you know, all the things that he says, I am, I am, I am.